Hello, I welcome you once again. I want to say, how are you doing? How is your family? How is everything? I hope the Lord is good to you. All right, so I want to talk about the issues of sowing seed that is going on in Christendom these days. Everybody is talking about sowing seed. Sow seed, $1,000, $500, $2,000. Very soon they will advance more. They will not be, if one did not put mouth into this, it's getting out of hand. Then I want to tell you, as a child of God, what sowing seed is all about. What is the meaning of sowing seed? Number one thing I want to tell you, that God never mentioned money as sowing seed. God never mentioned that. Jesus, that we are following, did not come into this world and begin to tell people to sow seed. Instead, He himself go ahead and sow the highest seed. What is the seed that he sowed? I want to explain to you. Jesus sowed himself. He put himself to earth. He gave himself, he sowed his life. That's why he reaped the highest. He became the author of eternal salvation. Listen very carefully. That's why Jesus, he became the author of eternal salvation. Even to the people that is going to be born, Jesus becomes their savior. Coming to seed, everything you are doing in this life is sowing seed. And the more you do good things, you are doing more things, you are putting things down that will be a blessing to you. Jesus gave himself, as I said to you, what is your pastor that is telling you to sow $1,000? What are they doing to you? What have they done to you? Jesus gave his life. He sowed his life for his disciples, for his children, for his followers, even for me and you that did not believe in him. He gave his life for me and you. What is your pastor giving for you that is even with him day and night? Jesus himself sowed a seed, preaching the word of God to the people. And when they are hungry, he is able to feed them. But your pastor centers this issue of seed on money. Anything you are doing in this life, you are sowing a seed. Listen very carefully. Anything you are doing, you are putting something down for your future. Something that you're going to harvest. Anything that you are doing, you are putting things down. The same way Jesus laid down his life and he became the highest. He became the highest. Even the next world that's come, he gave the highest. He sowed the highest. Your pastors are busy preparing abject poverty, everlasting poverty for themselves, for what they are doing. They think they are doing you. They are doing God's children. They are doing to themselves. As they are taking from you, they are preparing everlasting poverty and destruction and pains for themselves. It is very painful, and it is very, very disgraceful, and it's a cursed life for you to be taken from people without giving back. Bible says that blessed is the hand that give than the one that take. So if your pastors will be taken from you, they are already cursed. They are already cursed for them taken from you. They are cursed already. Jesus did not take from anybody because he understands the word of God. He himself is the word of God. That blessed is the one that gave. He gave the highest. God himself gave the world, the whole world, the highest in the person of his son Jesus. And that's why in return, he harvests the highest. So what I'm trying to tell you is, when you are doing anything in this life, you are sowing. When you give somebody that needed help, you give somebody, you're driving your car and you give somebody a lift, you are sowing. You sow with your car that God gave to you. When you are also a thief and an armed robber, you are stealing from people, you are also sowing something that you reap tomorrow. You are sowing something. When you are encouraging people, speaking good words to people, you are sowing a seed. When you help the poor and needy, you are sowing a seed. When you do anything good you are doing in this life, let me not mention them one by one. Anything good you are doing, you are sowing a seed. And anything evil you are doing, you are sowing a seed. In due time, you will harvest it. All of them that's lying with the name of the Lord, coming to tell you to sow seed of $1,000 that God says, so God, they are laying up curses upon curses that they will never finish reaping in this life, even in the life to come, even in the world to come. They are heaping everlasting destruction, everlasting punishment, everlasting pains and agony for their life, for themselves, and for their unborn children. They think they are doing you. They are not doing you. They are doing themselves. They are doing themselves. So what they are doing, Jesus came and he gave the highest. He put himself down. He sowed himself to the earth. And the earth vomits the highest for him. So your pastor is supposed to sow seed to your life. Give you money. Give you the word of God. Give you food. Give you everything you need. Stand by you to see that you become happy and successful in life from nobody to somebody. Instead, they are busy stealing from you. Can you see that what they plan for themselves is, I don't know how to put it, is everlasting poverty, shame, disgrace, alone using God. Using the name of God, they don't know the implication of what they are doing. By telling you to sow seed of $1,000, $2,000, you're sowing seed, you're giving money to a pastor, can't prosper you. It's not the thing that will cause prosperity for you. What will cause prosperity in your life is the more you receive the word, you study the word, God's word, the more you are growing in the word of God, you're becoming stronger in the realm of the spirit, the more you are doing good, the good you are doing consume you. Too much good. This is time you become powerful. Good to the poor and needy, good to the Muslim people, good to the Christians, good to everybody, everywhere you go. Bible says how God the Father anointed Jesus Christ of Nazareth, that's the Holy Ghost and power, who went about doing good. Too much good he did, caused him to inherit the throne of glory. To inherit the highest, even the world to come. So everything you are doing, I'm not about is sowing a seed, that is telling sowing a seed. A 419er is sowing a seed that you reap. A preacher man that preaches the truth of God's word and be a blessing to people is sowing a seed. That wins so for Jesus is sowing a seed. Somebody who also clean your shoe is sowing a seed. Somebody who wash your car is sowing a seed. A child of God who doesn't have money, but all that he can offer is to wash the car of a brother or a pastor is sowing a seed. You are going on the street, you see an old woman that is carrying heavy load. You help the old woman or the old man and carry something, give him a lift, you are sowing a seed. You take care of the helpless ones, the orphanage, you are sowing a seed. You preach the counsel of God without adding and removing, you are sowing a seed. You evangelize, you go and evangelize and win souls for Jesus, you are sowing a seed. So sowing a seed is all about doing the word of God, doing what Jesus said in his word, being good, doing good to everybody, doing good. Anything God gives to you, if it's a car, use it to do good. If it's a house, use it to do good. If you have so many clothes, use it to do good. Shoes, use it to do good. Money, use it to do good. Wisdom, use it to do good. Anything, power, anything God gives to you, use it to do good. It's all about, all of them is all about sowing seed. Not $1,000 seed, not $500 sowing seed, not $20,000 or $100,000 sowing seed. That one is, they are making you. They want to enrich themselves. They want to buy, maybe they want to buy better suit, or they want to buy cars, or they want to build house, or they want to buy jet. They are busy milking you. But don't worry, they are also heaping up everlasting pain and misery that they will never come out of. So this is what I want to tell you. When they come up with so seed, God never talked about money as the seed he's talking about. He's not talking about go about, use anything God gives to you to do good, to be a blessing to the kingdom of God, to be a blessing to humanity. God bless you.